H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Hello. Hi, everybody. This is Priya here. So we will continue with the quality center. And in the quality center, we were discussing the requirements. We completed this one. And we also completed the test plan. Then we have the test lab. Then the defects. Okay. So we will take up the test lab and defects. We discussed the test plan in the previous class, right? So in this class, we will see what is this test lab and then the defects. See, in the test lab, it's nothing but it is the test implementation and execution that we do. Okay. So test implementation and execution. So we will try to understand what exactly is this test lab and then also the defects module. So in this test lab, we can create the test set and then we can sequence the test cases. Then we can do the execution. So these are the three steps that we can do here in the test lab. We can create the test set and then we can do the sequencing. Then we'll do the execution of the test case. Okay. Any problem in my audio? Okay. So we will continue. Now from the test plan, I come to the test lab module over here. The first thing that I need to do is create the test set. Okay, so let's see how to create the test set. We have the root here. See, everybody observe the steps carefully. If you want, you note it down. Okay, first step is go to the test lab and then go to the root here. Create a new folder. If you want, you note down. Otherwise, what happens, you know, then later you forget, right? Okay. So in the test lab, root and then new folder. Okay, everybody note it down, please. Test lab, root, new folder. And we were testing the Bombino Express. So we will give the folder name as Bombino Express. Is it done? Then click on the OK button. folder will get created. Okay. So here the first step is create a folder in TestLab. Then secondly, create a test set. For that you have a second button over here. Do you see? So if you click on the second button, new test set window opens. Give the name of the test set. Currently we were testing the Bombino Express rates. So I can give here Bombino Express rates. So this is the name of our test set. Test set is nothing but group of test cases. Is a set of test cases for the Bombino Express rates. Click on the OK button. Do you see here? So I have created the test set. Okay. Any doubts still here? Creation of the test set. Click the folder, I mean create the folder and then create the test set. Okay. And after this, there is a select test button. You need to click on that. Okay, Reena, you want me to explain one more time? See here. Go to the root and then create the new folder. Hello. Yes, can you hear me, all of you? Okay, fine. Okay, see here, Reena, I'm repeating all the steps for you. Go to the test lab, root, create the folder. Okay, folder name, I will give it as Bombino Express because we were testing on this application. Then you click on the OK button. Do you see Bombino Express? Then second step is create the test set by clicking on the second button. And here give the set name, okay, the test set name. And then the test set name is, it is Bombino Express rates that we were testing. So we will be testing all the test cases that are related to Bombino Express rates. Is a set of all the test cases related to Bombino Express rates. Okay. Jaya, test set name is a name of a test set. Okay. So we are going to create the group of test cases, right? So I'm writing here Bombino Express rates. Or I can write it like this also. One second. Yeah. Bombino Express rates. Then click on the OK button. And after this, there is a select test button which you need to click. After you click on the select test button, you get the list of test cases here on the other side. Do you see here? You get the list of test cases which you should add here into the existing test set. Okay. So I can add the test cases over here. For example, Bombino Express home page load. Click on the arrow mark and then add it. So it is asking me the URL here because we had given the parameter as URL. So I enter here www.bominoexpress.com. Do you remember we had created the parameter yesterday, but we had not given the value. Value will be given here in the test lab. Then click on the OK button. So I've added the home page load. Then we have the our services rates. So I can add this our services. Then after that, our services rates. Okay. So I have added three test cases over here. One is the home page load, another is our services, and then our services rates. Okay. So after you click on the select test button, you get the list of test cases. Add the test cases into test set. Okay. So after you add the test cases to the test set, so this first thing is over, that is creation of the test set. The next thing that you should do is create the sequence. Okay. If parameter is not created, Parish, it will not ask you to enter the value. Karishma, it is not a test case name. It is a test set name. Okay. Means group of test cases. It is a group of test cases. It is not a test case. Then for the sequencing, we do it here in the execution flow. So we should come here to the execution flow. We had added how many test cases? 1, 2 and 3 test cases we have added. Home page load, our services and our services rates. And here whatever you can see, this Bombino Express rates, it is nothing but the name of the test set. Okay. Now we will see how to create the sequence. For the sequence, you need to go to the execution flow. I clicked here, execution flow. Have you noted down till here, everybody? You should click here on the execution flow. Yes, everybody noted? Yes, is it done, everybody? Have you noted till here? Okay. So now under this home page load, we want our services and then we want the our services rates. I want to change the sequence here. I want first home page load. Below that our services, below that rates. Let's see how to make the change. Now I want this our service below this home page load. I double click on our services. Note it down. I want this our services to be below the home page load. So I double click on this Bombino Express our services. Is it done? Yes, is it over? Okay, then click on the new button. Okay, so I have clicked on a new button. You can note it down that I have clicked the new button. Yes, is it okay, everybody? Okay, Divya, you want me to show how to click on a new button? See here. There is a new button here, Divya. Do you see here in the bottom? You should click on this new button. Is it okay, Divya? Did you follow? Okay. And after this, Bombino Express, our services runs only if home page load is finished. Okay, because I want to bring this our services below the home page load. So that is why I am writing here Bombino Express our services runs only if it is mentioned after the home page load. Yes, is it done everybody? I want this Bombino Express below the home page load, right? So I had double clicked on the our services. Now I select here home page load. Noted? Yes, have you noted everybody? Then click on the OK button. Okay, note it. You should click on the OK button. Yes, is it done everybody? Okay, and then again click on the OK button. One more OK button. So do you see here? The sequence is set. Is it clear all of you? Have you noted down all these steps? See, I will show once more. There is our services rates. I want it to come below the our services here. So again, I double click. New. This time select our services. Click on the OK button. Again click on the OK button. So do you see here? The arrow mark has changed. So we have set the sequence here. In this sequence we do the execution. First home page load, then our services, then our services rates. We are setting the sequence in which we want to execute the test cases that are present in the test set. Clear all of you? Now after this we have the execution. Let's see how to do the execution. Okay, can you tell me how you did the execution in the manual testing using the Excel sheet? Yes, how did you do the testing? using the test cases that we had written in the Excel sheet. So we were using the Excel sheet, we were executing the steps, okay? We were executing each and every step, entering the test data that we had given in the document. Then we were checking the expected results, correct? And we were noting down the actual results. In case there were any comments, we were writing them down. Now let's see how to do the execution here in the execution grid. Okay, that is in the test lab how to do the execution, we will see. Now here in the execution grid, let's say I select this home page load, click on the run button. Okay, for the execution, in the execution grid, select test case, click on run. Okay, shall I click on run? Note down everybody. So in the execution grid, select the test case and then click on the run button. So you click on the run button and I will show you a new window is going to open. See here. Do you see? A new window has opened. And after this, you get a begin run button over there. So you need to click on the begin run button. Clear all of you? Begin run button is there. So we will click on this. Have you noted till here? So I click here on the begin run. Do you see the step that we had written here in the test plan under the test case is appearing? Open the Bombino Express homepage in the browser. Test data URL is bombinoexpress.com. This is the test data that I had given. The expected results we had written. Our services tab opens with the rates as one of the option, right? So this is what the test case that we had written in the test plan, it opens for us. All the preconditions, steps, test data and also the expected result. And here we have the status. Now can you tell me how I do the testing here? See, instead of referring to the Excel sheet, we are referring to the quality center over here. So the step is mentioned. Open the Bombino Express homepage with the URL in the browser. So I need to perform the step. I go to the Bombino Express over here by typing the URL. So I have opened it and do you see our services tab with the rates as one of the option appears. So under here our services rates is appearing, correct? So what should I write here in the actual? Can you tell me, do you remember we had done the same thing in the manual testing? So what do I write here? What should I write? I should write as same as expected. Do you remember we were writing same as expected? Because under the our services, the rates was opening. So we write here same as expected. Status, pass or fail. So here we update the status in the result field, in the status. Okay. So only one step is there here. I click on this red color button to end the run. Is it clear, everybody, how to execute the test case and what time I executed, what date I executed? So everything gets recorded over here, date and time. Is that clear? Okay, Mona Lisa, you want to see again? See here, I'll show you again. Okay, we will go for our services and we will execute. Select the our services. Click on the run button. Then you have the begin run. So I had not entered the URL. It's asking me here. So if I don't enter in the test lab, it will ask me here. I can enter it. So you have two steps over here. The first step says that open the Bombino Express home page with a browser and with this URL. So I have opened here bombinoexpress.com in the browser. What is the expected result? It says that the Our Services tab with rates as one of the option should appear. So do you see here? Our Services, rates as one of the option appears, right? Then right here in the actual, same as expected. Then go to the status, change the status as passed. Clear? Then after this, go to the next step, read the step. Move the mouse over the Our Services or click on the Our Services. The different options should appear. Envelope, parcel, rates, movers. So go back here, move your mouse pointer over the Our Services. You have the envelope, parcel, rates. Do you see? All of them are present. So come back here and then write same as expected. And then here we will mark the result as passed. Is it clear, Mona Lisa? Okay, is it clear, everybody? Okay, now let's say here, in case the rates is not appearing. Rates option does not appear. Then what should I mark here? Yes, what should I mark? Okay, so rates option does not appear means it will become failed. So you should manually mark it as a failed. Okay, see, Quality Center is not an automation testing tool. Do you see here, instead of reading the Excel sheet and following the steps, I am reading this Quality Center and following all the steps. And after it is done, there is a end run red color button which I need to click. And do you see here, it is showing as failed. Okay, is it clear, everybody? All the steps you have noted down, right? So this is how you should do the execution. Select one test case at a time and then you can run it. Follow the steps, enter the test data, check the result and write the actual results. Mark it as pass or fail and then end the run. It will update the status here. Since one step has failed, it has come as failed. Even if there are 100 steps in a test case and even if a single step fails, it will come as failed. Okay. Okay, now how to report this as a defect to the developer? See, if you just mark it as a failed, it doesn't mean, you know, you are reporting it to the developer. You're just updating the status here. So let's see how to do the defect reporting using the quality center. You have the defects here. Okay, so here what we do is the test cases are created by a QA and execution could be assigned to a different QA. Okay, so for example, I have created all the test cases. You can come here and then you can add them into the test set, do the execution. Because it is a centralized system, right? All the testers will be able to access to this quality center. Okay, Parish. Now, for example, if I create the test case, you can come here into the quality center and you can execute the test cases that I have created. Okay, now let's see how to report the defect. To report the defect, I should go to the defects module over here. And this is the very simplest of all. In the defects module, I click on the new defect. All the details here will be opening. And you just have to fill out the details. Can you tell me what was the defect for us which we saw just now? What is the defect that we saw?
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.